I want to welcome you to the first seminar in our CRSO Learn at Lunch series titled Reconciling Patient Care Charges. We have four speakers today. Adriana Jenkins, she is the Clinical Research Administrative Support and Billing Integrity Manager. Patty Coleman, Patty is the Clinical Trials Financial Manager. Christy Peschke is the Business Intelligence Developer Senior, and Katarina Molina, who is the Associate Controller for UK Healthcare. I also want to remind everyone that if you complete, that you will receive an evaluation form today after this presentation. If you complete that evaluation at the bottom, there will be a link so you can get a certificate of attendance for your ACRP or SOCRA maintenance. So, Adriana, are you our first speaker? I think we're ready to go.
That's right. Can you all hear me okay?
Yes, we can hear you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. King. So we can start with the first slide, if you wish. All right, after seeing the lovely pictures, I will discuss today about the tier review process that occurs in an Epic, and it comes from data entered in Encore. So we can go to the next slide. I apologize, we have so many beautiful slides too. Share with you all. All right, as many of you are familiar with the coverage analysis or the billing grid that we perform in Encore, you have seen probably these billing designations. Normally, when you have a study with us and we perform the coverage analysis, you will see that we call bill, B-I-L-L, billing to patient or insurances. R is bill to sponsor or your grant. NA, non-billable or not billable, we don't use that very often because normally it will be something that is considered not billable, maybe your time and effort, which you see below as a supporting designation. So very often you will always see bill, R, and RT, which is research and time and effort. We can go to the next slide. All right, this is how the coverage analysis may look in Encore. We have done a few variations to the coverage analysis, not in how it looks like, but in mostly in the content. As you can see here, and many of you again are familiar with, in the Encore environment, when we review your protocol, what is going to happen is that you will receive a billing grid or financial calendar or a coverage analysis. Coverage analysis would only apply for qualifying studies. If your study does not meet the NIH definition of a clinical trial, or it is an NIH-defined clinical trial, but it doesn't qualify for the additional coverage, you're still going to receive an Encore participation. You're going to see the calendar the way it is here, and you're going to see designations. However, we will explain during the process what is NIH definition, if it meets the criteria, qualifying versus not qualifying, etc. The point of this is to show you that when you have an item, like for example here, what you have on the screen that is called RT, that time and effort is not tracked in Epic, not necessarily. Your bill designations or billing designations for insurance or the patient are going to be reflected in Epic, and I'm going to show you on the next slide. The way it translates into Epic from Encore is when you have your calendar and the calendar includes all items and services that you have outlined in your protocol, you're going to see that if your item is not in Encore, it's not nowhere in your on your calendar, it probably is a standard, what you call the standard of care, that is completely unrelated to your research study. That is for you and your study team to determine. So those are considered non-study charges. Remember, we at UK review all the conventional care services along with research services to every patient enrolled or participant enrolled in our studies. That means that when you are performing the tier one review, your bucketing is very important. That's why we have the coverage analysis and we have to split that between billing, research, or time and effort. You should use that coverage analysis or the billing grid or the financial calendar to split your charges, that is to bucket your charges. The second one is a study-related bill to study. What we normally have designated in Encore as our research is a research service paid for by the grant or the sponsor. That is, if that is on your calendar in Encore and your study is qualifying, that service must be linked to the bill to study, study related. That's one of the buckets. If your study is a non-qualifying study or non-NIH study, and I don't want to confuse you all, that probably does not apply. When we talk about study-related bill to study, that means that your claims are reported to Medicare, indicating that your participant is on a study. The third one that you see there, study-related bill to insurance, I apologize. When you have that bill in Encore related to standard of care, and I apologize, I confused the second one, is when your study is, your bill is a study related bill to study, it goes to your grant, that is market research. If your bill is a study related and is billed to insurance, that's when you're gonna see that bill designation as standard of care is part of the protocol, therefore is research related standard of care. We can go to the next one. What we do at the CRSO with tier one review is that we assist studies reviewing that tier one, and we help try or help you to process those charges. Meaning if you need help bucketing that, if you are not sure if that has to be designated standard of care related or unrelated, if you have any questions about how to process that tier one, you can contact us. The email address is there, CRSO Study Assist. And someone from our team will reach out and help you with that. We are somewhat familiar with the EPIC functionality, but keep in mind that our teams do not process accounts or billing in EPIC. So that means that if we don't have the information, we can point you in the right direction. If you are in EPIC, and this is a very good tip, is click F1 and you will see the resources. The team member handbook for research is very complete. It will help you to understand research orders, linking your study visits, things of that nature. If you need help with the system, if you're stuck in EPIC, remember on the right side corner of your EPIC screen, you're gonna find that button that says IT help. If you click on that button and you refer to the patient, the participant you're looking for, or your study, you can type in there what your problem is and they will connect with you. Next. All right, now I'm passing it to Katarina.
And if I could only unmute myself. Good afternoon. Thank you so much for joining us. And I am thrilled to be here because I am getting some of the questions about how do we go from research in EPIC to actually what you see in SAP. And I hope all of you have taken SAP classes and you know what I'm talking about. If not, you will definitely need it for your line of work. The JVs, journal vouchers, also known as journal entries. used to be a manual process. It was incredibly time consuming and prone to errors, because every time we have paper emails and people keying things in, as you know, errors happen. So last fall, we implemented a new process that actually automatically generates entries that go from Epic to SAP. The entries are happening, again, just as I said, auto-generated, no people involved, nobody's touching it. It is the information that is entered and stored in Epic on the study. So it is either WBS element that was added to Encore when the study started, or cost center. GL account in SAP that's related to research study is going to be 536120, and it is patient care. So sometimes I get an email that says, hey, I don't know why I have patient care, I shouldn't have. No, you should, if you are involved in any research or clinical study. That's the designated GL accounts across all UK, particularly for this reason. The documents that it's going to communicate to you that it is an interface from Epic to SAP is ZA. You know, SA is your manual transaction, SC are your accruals. There are all kinds of different document types. ZA is your Epic billing. Timing. Oh, the journal entries are generated for hospital billing daily. So as soon as the charge goes through three-tier reviews, first, your second, at the billing department or wherever they're in revenue integrity department, and the third tier review, as soon as that is completed, an entry will be generated the following day. So sometimes questions come up, I review something today, will I see it in my SAP tomorrow? And no, you will not, because it goes through different work queues and it will take a couple of days for the second and third tier review to happen. If tier review one is perfect, if there are any issues, you will have a communication back and forth. So that will delay the posting of the journal entry as well. And for professional billing PB, the entry is generated once a month. And it happens in the first few days of the month following the closed months, or on demand as needed. Next slide, please. Successful journal voucher. Things that are necessary for it to happen nicely and smoothly. Your grant, WBS element, it has to be in the open status in SAP. If it has been closed, we have grace period, or you are notified when the grant is going to be closed. So for the journal entry to pass, to post smoothly, it has to be in the open status. There has to be a budget for an entry to be posted. So it's not necessarily need to be on this cost center, on this GL account, but it has to be on that family. If you don't have a budget, it's usually will kick in into administrative or default cost center, or if you're over budget. So that thing will happen too. So sometimes your administrator will notice that you have patient care charges not on the grant, but in the administrative cost center, and then you'll have to resolve it. It's you would need to work with the budget officer to move the budget. Yeah, that's a good reminder. If there are any issues, you need to move the budget, you have to work with your budget officer and reclassify budget, move from different categories to where it belongs. If you actually have to move a transaction from the administrative cost center to your WBS element, then you'll have to follow the rules of it will be considered an error correction and not a direct charge. So there will be a lot of documentation that you will have to have in order to submit a journal entry to correct it. So again, anything can be done, but Highly recommended to have the budget set up in advance so that will assume the smooth posting of expenses for your study to your grant accounts. I think that is it for me. And if you have any questions, please ask. We'll be happy to answer.
All right, everyone, I'll pick up from here. So I think pretty much everyone on this call probably knows how to get into SAP and how to look up the charges that have posted once the journal voucher posts. But we're going to step through it just in case there are some people who need a little bit of assistance. So after your first tier review that Adriana spoke about, and after the journal voucher is actually posted to SAP that Katarina's just talked about, you're going to find that your journal voucher is in SAP, and you're going to want to review the details. So I'm going to demo how to find the JV in SAP, and then Christy is going to demo how to run the reports to pick up your detail. So the first thing you're going to want to do is to get into your IRIS. Next slide, please. Okay, and we are going to use the annual versus the actual, the annual budget versus actual transaction code. So this is the S_ALN_ and then a 01, 5 zeros, and a 3. Okay, next slide. Okay, when we get into our budget versus actual, we're going to choose our expense only variant. You're going to enter your account number and the posting dates. The example that Christy is going to walk us through today occurred in October and November of last year. So you'll enter your dates or whatever date it is that you're looking for in SAP. And then down here at the bottom, you'll notice if you will choose this bottom radio button, it will break your report out for you by sponsored class. And that will help you to locate your journal vouchers a little easier. Okay, next slide. All right, when you get into SAP, here's your sponsored class, the E536120. It will show you the journals that have actually posted to the account. So the examples that we're going to look at today are these two journals that posted in October and November of last year. Okay. Lori, I'm going to demo real quickly. So if you could stop sharing, and I'm going to share. All right. All right. All right. Everybody can see my SAP screen. All right. So just like we talked about, you're going to use your IRIS beach ball. We're going to pull up a session here. All right. All right. So like I said, we are going to choose our budget versus actual. We're going to use our expense only T code. All right, we're going to enter our grant and our posting dates. And then I'm going to use my radial button here at the bottom. And then I'm going to execute. All right, once that comes up, I'm going to scroll down. Generally, it's toward the bottom. And here are your journal vouchers that have posted for the months of October and November. Just a couple of things to note. Like Katarina said, it is the 536120GL. And all of your journal vouchers will start with a 6 and 4 zeros. And then your unique number. When you click into the journal, what you'll notice is that you can see a lot of entries. So all of these entries are patient care charges that have posted, but there's no detail behind this. So that is why we need the reports that Christy's going to demo to allow you to see all of the detail behind the charges. Okay. All right. I'm going to stop sharing and I'm going to hand it over to Christy.
Thank you. Can you get the presentation back up? I'll start with that. There we go. So I'm Christy Peschke. I'm from the Business Intelligence Reporting team. And one of the concerns that we had heard was, once it's an SAP, how can I reconcile this back to the charges within Epic? And so we've created this Tableau report. And part of the reasons why it's in Tableau versus Epic is we were able to do a lot more formatting and make this a lot easier to the end user. So I'm going to start here, and then I'll show you how to access it within Tableau. But we have two different versions. We've got one that's going to look at this for journalized, and then there's also a version. So if you wanted to see accounts before they're journalized, you can go see what the active charges are. It's in a similar format. And the way this report is built, it's going to automatically, when you open it up, default to a start and end date of the prior month, but you can go in there and change these dates. When you change the date, it's automatically going to run. So if you change your start date, it's automatically going to go out there and pull data. Right now, it takes it a couple of minutes because it's got to go out there and pull all of the research transactions. And then, so it's going to take it a little bit, but that's why we have it default to the prior month. So you'll set your start and end dates. And once those are set, we've got some additional filtering that you can do. We allow for system adjustments. By default, we are excluding those, so you don't see any of those. We are only pulling active transactions. So this is going to be what's actively affecting your balance and the amount that's JV'd. If you do want to see charge corrections where things might have been corrected, you may want to toggle that to it's defaulting to all, but you could toggle it between just actives, not actives, but that way you can see. And then we have a filter where you can filter down by your research study. If you can go to the next slide, and I'll demo this live in just a minute. But for this purposes, I've filtered this down to the study that Patty was using before. And so I'm able to, in the little search bar, type Bravo. It automatically pulls me up any studies that have Bravo within that name. So even if you're just giving it a portion of it, it is a smart search. And it automatically defaults to that. And once you have your studies selected, you can either, down at the bottom, you can either go to the summary or to the detail. So next slide, please. And so if I go to the summary here, this is just going to pull back the transactions within Epic that match to those JV transactions that are within SAP. So this is just my summary. So it's going to summarize it by day. You may notice in SAP that when the transaction goes over to SAP, all positive transactions are sent as one transaction and all negative transactions are sent as one transaction. But here within this report, they're summarized and flattened down into one single JV transaction, because this is just a summary by day. So you can see the total amount that hit on 10-3 was 27-47, 40-something. That covered 27-47-47. And then in November, we had another JV for $1,202.25. So between those months, it does an automatic totaling. You'll also see that there's an Excel link that will automatically open and export the data out to Excel in a nice formatted method. It will look just like this on the screen. It's already pre-formatted for you with all the totals and everything. So next slide. Then the other option you have is the actual detail. So this is going to be the detail. I've scrubbed out some information off of this, but you'll see whether or not this was originally an HB or a PD account. What the WBS element is, the research study name, the actual account number. So if we ever needed to go track this back into Epic and see exactly, we know where these charges landed. We have a discharge date. These are client accounts. So the discharge date is always the end of the month. What the transaction type is, if there was a patient, whether it would be a patient, what the patient name is, the date that it posted, the service date, as well as the CPT. This is a summary, so it summarizes everything by day. So you'll see where it's going to summarize each line. And then the amount. So sometimes down here, further down, you'll see where they had four of the same thing done. And it's a summary. So it's not all the way down to the transaction line. It is a detail. If you go to the next slide. Again, this is like too big to have shown all in one slide. So I've just kind of chopped it apart. But as you would go down through this study, you'll get to a summary page. Same summary here. So the total number of charges equals 27,47,47. And then we have that credit adjustment. And these, the CPT of 50,36, these are going to be the transactions that match your SAP. So you'll notice this is this research month end adjustment that's done in Epic is the equivalent to what is done over in SAP. If you see any other adjustments, those are not what match to SAP. It's just the 50,36s. And again, so this is going to summarize by account, by study, all of your charges, and it is exportable. So whatever you've got selected on the parameter page, and then you go to the detailed report, it can automatically be exported if you need to do further analysis. I think I've got another slide, if you can go to that. Yeah, so this just shows you at the very bottom, after we've gone through all of the charges on this Bravo study, that for these 2 months, we now have a total balance of zero. So everything has been adjusted off within Epic, and the JV has been submitted over to SAP. So that's what this is showing. And you can see this is a good example where there's a slight credit adjustment where we've made a contractual allowance of 2 cents. That is not reflected in SAP. It's just balancing out within Epic. Is that contractual? So those adjustments are not part of what is JV. So let me share and I will show how we get to this, I think. Yeah, so we'll start with this slide first. To get access to this Tableau report, we have the Business Intelligence, there's a data request link at datarequest.ukhc.org. This is where you can either request new reports or request access to existing reports. So,
Christy?
Yes.
We're not seeing that. I think we're still seeing the slide deck.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I'm just describing now. So, this is just to get access to this report.
I thought you
meant
you were going
to
share. I got you.
I am going to share in just a second to show what it looks like. But this is, I forgot that I had this link in here. So, this is just how you would access this Tableau report and how you would request access. So if you don't have access, this is where you'll go to request the access. And then if you have any further questions after this this demo, we do have finance office hours every Thursday mornings. And this is where we field questions from users on reporting needs, how-tos, Epic how-tos, and then any content that we have built additionally for people to ask questions and help triage some of the questions that they may have. And it's all on this one page. Let me share here. Sweet. Okay. So here at UK, there's a Tableau server, tableau.ncy.edu. And let's hopefully it don't crash. And here, once you have access to the you can scroll down. I may crash. My computer does not like Zoom. Sorry, my computer really, really hates Zoom. So again, like I was saying, this is where we have all Tableau reports here, and there's a research billing folder with the two different reports. There's a journalized research billing. This is where everything that has been journalized, and this is all research. The all research does take a lot longer to run because it's based on a different date criteria. But it could be helpful if you wanted to validate that current charges that are being, as you approve charges and they are prior to journalization, that they, that the charge amounts are correct. This could be a useful report. It pulls everything that's, that is on a research account. This one is pulling basically where things have been journalized. So if you click this, I've gone ahead and run it here for the example we were just looking at. So the way this works is you can change your start and your end dates. This is based on a JV date. So this would be, you're wanting to look at what happened this month, last month, the prior month, you're reconciling to SAP. So we've got this dependent on the JV date, whereas this other report here is dependent on the account date. So I want to look at my current month's account. I would look at something with a discharge date or prior month, maybe. I want to look at my August charges that have a JV. I would pick my, it would be based on an account date, not on a JV date. So that's the difference between these two. So you would select this. You can choose whether you want to include or not include some adjustments, and then whether or not you want all transactions, ones that are not active. So these could be transactions where the charges, the price has changed, or just all are active. And then here, you can just type whatever you would like to type, and it automatically enter, it'll automatically go out there and find Bravo. There, there's our Bravo. Helps if I actually type correct. So it lets you go out and it will automatically search for whatever study you would like to search for. And like I said, it does do intra, try to find one there. So that's everything with the word REV in the middle of it. It will search. It's a smart search. And once you do that, select, you can click your research study, multiple ones, and then choose whether you just want to see the summary that we've seen before or the actual detail. So I'm gonna, that has PHI, so I'm gonna close that out. But so that's just a quick demo of how to utilize the report to validate our your charges that and how, what was JV'd within SAP. I have produced a tip sheet that is available that will also step-by-step show you how to go through this report and run the report and give some tips and tricks on how to change your dates and what each date range means and how to select your study. But like I said, here we go. This is, it does export directly out to Excel, which I know was one of the big requests to begin with, was something that we could put in Excel and modify. So, stop sharing. So that was kind of fast, but are there any questions? And I think that's the end of our presentation. I think I was the last one.
Hey, Christy, where could we find the tips in a trick sheet?
It says it looks like we'll be included with the survey at the end.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Yeah, I sent the link. So, and like I said, if there are any questions on the report that I built, we do have office hours, and that link is at thatdatarequest.ukhc.org. And it's every Thursday morning at 9 a.m. And I am available outside that time, but that's just our general, like, always available time is that time.
We've got one question in the chat from Darren, and he's asking what the processes or the method is for handling WBS elements in Encore, especially those that change annually or change ever. Patty, do you want to take that? Do you want me to take that?
Sure. Right. Yes, Darren, we are able to make changes to that account in Encore when the new account number becomes available. So yes, that can be changed as needed. Do we have other questions? Okay. Jessica, did we have anything else that we needed to cover?
I don't see any other questions in the chat, but certainly if anybody has any questions later, feel free to reach out to any of us and we will do our best to help you answer them.
Hey, good afternoon. I've got the floor. I have a second to answer. You got a minute?
Yeah.
Yes.
So as thinking about the Tableau report and the access to the journalized information, I guess what credentialing process is allowing people not like me to get access to it so we don't disclose PHI to people who don't need it? And then is the report itself, if called only that to which I get access, is it only my studies? To which then would beg the question, how do I go about getting other studies added? Or is that somehow like wide open for every possible study that's open and available at the university in the building process?
So as of right now, it is not row level security. If you have access to look at the EPIC data, you have access to all of the studies and see all of the charges to other studies. We don't have it locked down by study. I think we have discussed that. And it was determined that this level of security was okay. As far as getting access, when you request access, it goes to somebody who maintains the list of who has access to what within the Tableau server. So there's one person that does give the access to the various reports, and we maintain who has that access.
And so the mechanism by which somebody like me would say, oh, by the way, you know, Jimmy Bob no longer works for me anymore, and now needs to be removed, is that simply turning in a request to HCIT?
Yeah, it would be going that request access link, that same request access link, and asking that somebody's access be revoked to that Tableau report.
Going back to the information related to the when there's not sufficient budget set up on your WBS to handle the expense, blah, blah, conversation. At some point, I think the billing report probably reflects the WBS or the cost center to which it's meant to post to, and probably not the actual cost center they're posted to. Would that be correct? So if I've listed whatever $100,000 for expense and listed on grant number one, which is a, you know, whatever, not right number, but if I listed on grant number one that grant that had sufficient budget to handle it, and it bounced off to my local departmental administrative call center as described, which I think we're agreeing is the indirect overrun, would the bill, I think you would agree, would not list the indirect overrun call center, but rather the account number or the grant to which it was intended, correct?
I think you are correct. So if I understand your question correctly, Daryl. So in Encore, you set up the WBS element, but it is either over budget or does not have the budget on the correct budget family. And in SAP, it will hit the default cost center instead of grant, right? In Tableau, you are looking at things by the study name more. So that what will be listed there will be actually what is attached to that study in EPIC. So it would be the WBS element. Also, in the default cost center, if you look at the journal entry, it will actually mention that actual WBS element that it tried to post it to. Like, I think it will be in the text field.
That I understand how to do, but I can't speak for the audience whether they can find that information. But I was going back to the journalized entry report and questioning whether it would list the originally intended grant or call center, or would it list, in fact, the final one in which it really posted to.
It will list the initial grant, the one that you intended to use, because that report is based on the information from EPIC. The cost will change to the default on the way from EPIC to SAP. So EPIC sends the correct cost center. SAP says, you don't have budget on this WBS element.
Yeah. And if I could suggest before the tip sheet sent out that maybe either it includes, if it doesn't already, some information about from an RFS standpoint to make sure that people are given guidance for how and when to list within EPIC the new grant number or the new cost center number to which they should post expenses, because expenses, you know, in terms of like adding early or adding late to EPIC, the new account number could impact the billing and either allow or not allow that eventualized generalized venture or JV posting. And that may be a timing thing because of when the budget period relates to the, you know, the grant funds. And so I don't know if Patty has, you know, knowledge of working in that kind of area, but I can imagine there's going to be people out there in which their grant funded ended on, let's say, 831, and they still have listed in EPIC the old account number, and maybe bills are coming to, you know, continue to come through on the old account number because either they don't have the account number, the new one set up yet, or they may not even have it. So then the question becomes, what would you all recommend for doing those situations for expenses that need to post, but the you know, the new year account number is not set up correctly or not set up right or whatever, not available, not even available kind of thing. So if I could suggest from an RFS standpoint that you all look at that period of performance related compliance issues, I would appreciate it.
Yeah, that's a great point. I think we do need to look into it.
Yeah. And so if it is true that the journal voucher won't post on a grant that is expired, I think you said that right, Katarina, that you get a error message if the journal tries to post on an expired. So then it would roll to your overrun, at which point then you would have to do a journal voucher to move it to the newly established account once that account is available. But the word that we have given everyone is that as soon as the account number becomes available, they need to enter it into Encore immediately. That's our request, because exactly what you're saying, Darren, it will keep patient care charges from posting properly. So that is what we are recommending.
Yeah, going back to the account closes a status on the account and not really the budget period dates in which the would drive the allowance or not for expenses to post. And I would suggest that if anybody has a situation where they know that a new year account is coming for a new budget period start, that they don't wait for the 1, 2, 3 months for that new account to be set up. They need to be updating their EPIC profile to list a cost center so that the expenses don't post to the old year wrong account simply because you don't have the new year grant account. If that doesn't make any sense, I explain maybe offline or, you know, further if it's confusing whatsoever, but I don't want to beat a dead horse there, but because I would like to assume that everybody knows what the budget period and how that relates to allowances or not regarding the period of performance expenses.
Right. Yep. Those are all great points, Darren. All right. Do we have other questions? All right. Okay. I think we are finished. Thank you all so much.
Thank you all.